First of all, if you're here for the first time, hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up.
What kind of us are you? Welcome them.
Okay, welcome back.
Welcome to this channel. If you're new, hi. I'm Crystal. She's Belema. If you're not new, welcome back, fam. How are you doing?
Oh my god. Alright, you guys. So I think by now you should be feeling very welcome.
Yeah.
So if you're here for the first time, my name is Belemarchh, and this is my sister, Christabel. And yeah, subscribe to our channel. I mean, we bring the hits like back to back.
We do.
Okay, so today we're going to talk about controversial issues that are not usually being talked about in society just for different reasons. Mm-hmm. And we're just going to share our opinions about these topics. And
I think, I mean, maybe to some of you, it might feel like it has been talked about like maybe once or twice, but like we're just going to give our
own opinions. No, it's okay.
Yeah,
we're just going to give our opinions.
Yeah.
About these things. First of all, this wig is from Natural Hair Rocks. You guys should go and patronize my girl.
I don't have a wig, but like this wig is it, man. Like, actually, it goes either way. You can do side parted.
You can do side. You can do like extreme side. You can make it a ponytail. It's like everything. You can do like the half do.
Yeah.
It's like so good. And this is not a sponsor.
This
wig is really nice. It's called Wig Mabel. It is from Natural Hair Rocks. I'm going to put their stuff here and a link to her Instagram page in the description box down below, so you guys can go and get it. Patronize her, you know, like when you see a Nigerian brand doing well, it's good to like encourage and like definitely be a channel for their growth. So what else was I going to say? Oh yeah, this is not a paid ad. That's what I was going to say. Like, she didn't pay me. She didn't ask me to do this or anything. So yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video. All right. So the first topic we're going to talk about is job shaming.
Yeah.
So basically, what this means is looking down on somebody because of the kind of job that they do.
Yeah. Or just like looking down on like a job, like a certain career.
Yeah.
Like working in McDonald's. Okay, I'm guilty of this because like I've said this many times. Like, had like rants and up with me saying.
Hello.
So like I've like ended rants with me saying something like if I don't do well in school I'll end up in McDonald's. But like one of my friends like helped me realize the fact that if you don't work in McDonald's, how will you get your McDonald's? When you go there and shop, how would you get your food? Like if no, I mean like sure there's machines and stuff to like where you can actually like order your food from.
But like somebody has to make it. Somebody has to flip it in the kitchen.
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah.
Like, if you've seen the movie about what they call How McDonald's Started, I can't remember the name of the movie. But like, you see how, like, how
the
strategic.
Founder.
Yeah, the movie about. Yeah, yeah, that was the name of the movie. How strategic, like, the whole, like, kitchen setup was and how long they practiced, like, just that movement in the kitchen, that fluency and everything. I don't know if, like, they have this. If maybe they've changed it from now.
Yeah.
But, like, that commitment was crazy, like just like watching how committed people were to making one thing
the
succeed
dream happen,
yeah. And the dream that they pushed and tried for. We don't have a right to shame them, like we don't have a right to shame someone's idea. I mean, even if you shame them, it's not going to change the fact that you go to McDonald's and you order and the person still makes money. It's not going to change that fact. But like, just don't put other people down. Like, in your head you probably isn't putting like the job down, but just don't do it.
And I feel like as long as the person's not doing anything illegal, you have no right to open your dirty mouth and say, oh my gosh. Okay, let's imagine something here. So imagine if I get a job here in Dubai and I get a job in McDonald's. Let's use McDonald's as an example, right? And then somebody from Nigeria comes and they see me working in McDonald's here, and then they're like, ah shit, I went to Dubai but I was working in McDonald's. So? So? Who are you? Do you get, as long as I'm not prostituting, I'm not scamming, but I'm not doing Yahoo Yahoo like some of your boyfriends and your fathers, then I see no reason why I should be shamed for the job I do. Do you understand?
Yeah.
I feel like even cleaning, like it's like if somebody has to do it, if they don't do it, who will do it? Not everybody will be the MD or the CEO or whatever.
Exactly.
So like, it just doesn't make sense. Job shaming does not make any sense to me.
Okay, so, now let's jump from what people see as joker jobs to like what people see as actual jobs. And I've seen like lots of quotes that got me so angry where it's like, I don't want to work a 9-to-5, I'll be an entrepreneur. But like, if somebody doesn't do that job, who's going to do it?
And even apart from that, not everybody's meant for entrepreneurship.
Yeah, exactly. I feel like I'm meant for a 9-to-5 job. Like, I can't I can't just be like, yeah, sure, I can be like an entrepreneur and have my own thing on the side. But like, if I'm doing like a job, I don't want to just have like a job where I wango up and down.
What does that mean?
Like where I'm just like, yeah, sure, how the day comes, I'll take it. I'm not that kind of person. I'm kind of person that need a plan. Like, yeah, sure, I may not stick to it on point. But, like, I need to have that plan because that's what gives me my like stability. That's what makes me feel like I'm doing something. Mm-hmm. But like, if you, that, I don't know, that day I was just really angry because it was just like, so like, for example, how, like, I want to be a clinical psychologist. So you with all your problems, like, I'm not shaming any mental health issues or anything, but like, you have your issues and you bring them to someone who worked a 9-to-5 job. You have your monetary issues. You bring them to someone who has a 9-to-5 job. So why would you
open your mouth? Shame somebody for having a 9-to-5. It doesn't make sense.
I mean, like, yeah, sure, you may want to be an entrepreneur. Go ahead, be an entrepreneur. Start your own thing. You go, girl. Yeah, exactly.
Wait, so let's not talk like, what's it called? Like, we're both against 9-to-5.
Yeah.
I'm more entrepreneurial. Like, I'm the more entrepreneur. I'm more 9-to-5. I'm always wanting to start this business and all that. But like, I won't shame somebody for having a 9-to-5 because I know that being an entrepreneur is not an easy thing.
Yeah.
Honestly, like, if not for the fact that I don't know how, I need a job that's always going to have, like, that's always going to keep changing.
Like,
if I'm going to do a 9-to-5, yes, like consulting, PR, stuff like that. That's like the kind of job I can. That's the kind of 9-to-5 I can do. But stuff like accounting, I would get bored on the job because it's like, it's quite monotonous. I know every day I'm dealing with like numbers. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Numbers don't change. Trading profit and loss accounts will never change. Balance sheets will never change. There's nothing revolving around. Do you understand what I mean? Mm-hmm. So like, for me, that's a monotonous job. Something like consulting, where I'm dealing with like different companies and stuff like that, the problems might be similar, but they will never be the same, and the approach to solving the problem will always be different. So like, that's just what, that's just like my own kind of thing. So we're not like against against them, just against entrepreneurs or whatever. I'm also an entrepreneur, so like, it's not
like, also like, I'm not when I said like, I don't want to wake up and just be doing my like going free in the wind, I'm not trying to have people who can't do that and do it successfully are like bad or anything, but like, that's your niche, that's just not my thing.
You know the funny thing about people that jobs, many of them don't have jobs. That's one thing I've noticed. Like, your job shaming another person for like working in McDonald's or being a cleaner or whatever, but then you yourself, you don't have a job. So like, what are you talking about? Or you're still living on daddy's money and you have the guts to open your mouth and shame somebody else? Shame on you.
Honestly,
it doesn't make any sense. So like and then, you know, this whole idea, like, moving from job shaming, this whole idea of everybody wanting to succeed now. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, nobody wants to put in the time, the process, the work, everything. See, everything is a process,
True.
So that they need to succeed right now, especially for like 90s babies. Something that I kind of feel like, I feel the pressure sometimes, but I tell myself to always trust the process. Even though, yes, I'm not making all the money I want to be making right now, or like, sometimes I feel like, oh, I can't wait to be at this point in time of my life. Like, it's the waiting and what's it called?
Like,
the process of getting to where I want to be is like, Jesus. But like, that's a necessary process. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. I feel like in the end, like, it pays off. Like, it will pay off. Like, I mean, like, you know, something I read recently was, anything worth doing is worth doing at least 20%. It's like, you can half-ass something, but half-assing it every day will still lead to like something, at least like a basis that you can go off of.
Yeah,
like, it will lead to, just like when like you really know in the mood to study and like you just do, okay, let me just do 5 minutes, it's going to, you may get more interested. Yeah, just do 5 minutes and you just tell yourself, okay, maybe I can do 5 minutes more, and then obviously you may see, at the end of the day, you may see yourself studying for 2 hours straight without like needing a break, like maybe an hour, but like, or even 30 minutes, or like 10 minutes, but like, it will be worth it. It would be like something like, let's say, what if what you studied actually comes out in your exam, that kind of thing. So like, just always put in an effort.
A bit of effort.
Like, just a bit of
effort. I don't know how we got to this topic. I don't know how we got here. But like, what's called, another example of like half-assing things is, wait, let me say that again. Another example of half-assing things is like my YouTube channel.
Yeah,
I could have started with a team. I could have gotten a videographer, I could have gotten an editor, I could have gotten a content creator, everything. I'm just the face of the brand and gone for it. But like, here's the thing, I don't have the money for that. I cannot just talk like that. Besides, for me, it's like, I don't think it's that serious yet. But like, always get to a point where I can hire all these people and do all these things, like, by choice. But like, the fact that I have this experience now, nobody can swindle me and say something like, oh, because I'm editing your video, I'm using Final Cut Pro. So like, nah, fam, I use that and like, we're good. I know how to, if you don't do it, I can do it. You understand what I'm saying? So it's like, you're dispensable. So behave yourself. So I feel like the process will definitely teach you things that are necessary.
Yeah.
So trust the process. Another thing is greed.
What do you mean?
I feel like it's greed that makes people not want to go through the process, and people also don't want to look small. How do I explain it?
Oh, like starting small.
Yeah.
They don't want to like see like people that as the image that, of what people being, see them as, like being niched to like small things. Yes. I guess.
Yes, I feel like the process of start. You know how like now everyone's looking at Davido and all these people like spending money and all these kind of things. Like people want to be there so bad that they don't think of the fact that that's not where we are at now. Right now, 930 naira in the account. We need to make this money. You get what I'm
saying? Like going back to like even when you go back to people's like maybe Oprah's first interview, like how she got fired from her first job. Like sure, there will be like some setbacks. But know that every time you keep putting in more effort, there's always going to be an outcome.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, look at it all as like a tapestry of your life, yeah? Every small, every stroke, every little stitch is going to make a difference in your story. And in the end of the day, when you look at it, it's going to be beautiful.
You're so smart, my God. She's so smart. I'm so proud.
Aww.
But yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
Just learn to trust. First of all, we ended up talking about jobs and career and all that in this whole video, but like I think that trusting the process is very important. One, two, don't shame people because of where they are at now, because the tables can turn very easily. Don't even sweat it. Tables can turn very easily. And then I feel also one other thing that we should talk about is when you're in the position where the tables have turned and where you're like in the place of success, let me say this way: when you finally take the elevator and you're at the top, make sure you send the elevator back down, meaning make sure you always like try and help somebody else come up, because at the end of the day, guess what, if the tables now turn against your favor, the person that you helped up is still the person that's going to send the elevator back down for you to come up again. So like when you're in the position to help somebody, even if it's a retweet, even if it's a repost, even if you help people when you can, it's very important.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Like the story of Kevin Hart and Tiffany
Haddish. And Tiffany Haddish.
Oh, my God. So, that's literally the perfect example of sending the elevator back down for someone else. Like, now, if anything should happen, like, I mean, we can never tell if maybe one day he's going to be in a position where she was. And she, like, in case you know what I'm talking about, just like maybe Google it or something, because I can't start
explaining. Yeah,
it's very long. But like that's like the perfect example of that kind of like giving back to the community, or like giving back to just like anybody that you see
to your industry.
Giving back to your industry. Yeah, that's basically it. Yeah.
And then don't feel like scared to like help somebody so they don't become bigger than you. Let me tell you, what is for you is forever for you. Like, it's just like saying, okay, like how some big YouTubers now will not collaborate with smaller YouTubers because they feel like, oh, I worked hard to get here, so you should put in your own work too. I agree, but at the same time,
you could be
you can help, you could be
the boost that they need to get to that level.
And the fact that they get to that level doesn't mean that they overtake you. Do you understand what I'm saying?
But at the same time, doesn't mean that they won't. it doesn't mean that they would.
And even if they do, they will never step on you. Like, and if they do, then they're shit, and these tables are going to turn in their own.
Comes from like a place of instability, like fearing that someone else will do better and you just because you help them. Like, you helped in the process. Be proud of your character. I mean, don't do it just because you can be a good person, like be morally right or that kind of thing. But like, do it because you genuinely want to help and because it's the right thing. Do it because it's the right thing to do, not because it will look right to others, but because it is the actual right thing to do.
Yeah, I agree. So I think we've done good, right? So all right, you guys. So I hope that we've made sense. It's basically just like a rant, it's not like rant, rant, but like it's just like small thoughts video. So we hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in our...
Wait, let's recap what we thought then.
Okay. So a quick recap. Don't job shame people, because everybody's putting in their work into what they're doing.
Trust
the process.
Send the elevator back down.
Send the elevator back down, because tables can turn easily.
Yeah.
And there was something else.
I don't remember.
You said something before sending the elevator back, Abby.
Yeah, we did.
I can't remember, but like, yeah, you get the gist.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't judge same people, trust your process, and always help when you can. Mm-hmm. Thank you guys so much for watching our video, and
we hope you liked it.
Yeah, because this is not like one of our, this is not a kind of video that we usually just do, like fun videos, but like it's important to sit down every once in a while and reflect and talk about things that actually really matter.
Right.
All right, so we hope you guys liked our video. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.
And if you have, if you ever have any problems or anything, you can always come to her DMs. I won't say mine, because like you probably won't feel like need to talk to me, because like I'm younger than most of you. That's
see, Christopher is young, but like, she's very smart. Like I come to her with like adult issues, and she has never let me down, not once, not ever. So like, and her advice is always like. So if you don't feel comfortable talking to me, you can definitely talk to Christopher. If you're closer to her age, or even if you're not, you just need like the opinion of like. A child. So you can always like talk to her, but like my email is open. I do DM Belemarchh, so if like if you DM me or if you message me, whatever, I'm very open to talk about stuff with everybody. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, you guys, and we'll see you in our next video.
Bye. Oh, psych.